Welcome back, everyone. Well, it's a classic hit that took off 40 years ago and is still soaring, Airplane. And here to tell me all about it is David Zucker. All right, David, thank you so much for joining me. So first of all, I just want to thank you for putting out amazing films that we all love. Let's talk about Airplane. This is the 40th anniversary for this film. First of all, did you think that it was going to be such a big hit back then when you released it?
Well, actually, yes. Just, you know, we had written it 5 years before, and we couldn't get it back. And finally, Paramount, we convinced Paramount this would be a big hit. So when it actually was a big hit, we absolutely expected it. But what we didn't expect was that 40 years later, it would still be quoted, and it's still, I mean, people, it just hasn't aged.
It hasn't aged, and I think this is what you're so good at, is taking something that's so real and really just kind of making fun of it. I mean, these aren't comedians that were doing this. These were just really serious actors, and they made everything so funny. Why do you think it resonated with so many people? And even now, 40 years later.
Yeah, well, that was, both the advantage and disadvantage of this concept. if you can imagine, we went into Paramount saying, we want to do a comedy without comedians. And this was like Columbus saying, well, there's land out there, and everybody, you're crazy. The earth is flat. Anyway, so somehow Michael Eisner of Paramount decided to take a chance on it. And the budget was low enough. So, the jokes, if you think about them, I am serious and don't call me Shirley, would probably not be as funny with Jim Carrey or Kevin Hart. Not that those guys aren't fabulous, but it's just, you just need to not put any comic spin on it, and just these guys who had never done comedy, it worked because it was a spoof on very serious movies.
And what was the craziest thing? I mean, it had to have been funny to be on set, but back then, if you can, remember, it was obviously a long time ago, but what was one of the craziest, the funniest things that just happened?
Well, it was pretty businesslike on set because, we would put the jokes, we'd have the actors rehearse on set right before shooting, and the crew would crack up. But there wasn't any ad-libbing. This is not the kind of comedy where you let somebody ad-lib. It's just, it's very, they got to say the lines. But, one thing that did crack the actors up was Leslie Nielsen would bring this little diaphragm thing, a fart machine. And it would make farting noises.
Oh,
and he would do it like right in the middle of one of Bob Hayes' lines and totally screw up the take. And so we started selling them to everybody, all the crew on the set, and everybody would do it. We finally had to ban it from the set.
One of the things that you love to do and you're passionate about is Treat People LA. So tell me about it.
Well, I'm from Wisconsin, and so if you are from the Midwest.
The Midwest, yeah.
There you go, that trees just grow. I mean, they just, you just let the land alone, the trees will go. And so when I came out here, there weren't so many trees. And I joined an organization headed by one of my best friends, not at the time, but he became one of my best friends, Andy Lipkus, and it's called Tree People. And you can go to their website, treepeople.org, I think. And it's just an amazing environmental group.
Well, that's definitely something that we need, and it's a great cause. So thank you so much, and so looking forward to the 40th anniversary of Airplane. And take care.